If you've been following along, you know the ins and outs of the four C's. You can grade clarity, know how to spot small variations of color, you know the signs of true artistry in a cut, and you're measuring your bench press in carats. Cool half mil for me. But there is another choice we haven't discussed yet. Natural diamond or lab grown? There's a myth that lab-grown diamonds are inferior to natural, but there's also a myth that a unicorn tear can grant a wish. Oh, that's bull. This diamond was formed naturally, deep in the earth over billions of years. This one was grown in a lab last month. But chemically, optically, and physically, these are a perfect match. There's no difference at all. Except one. Natural diamonds are formed in the earth over billions of years through a special process that's too complicated to explain. Some people believe diamonds were placed here as seeds by ancient aliens. Those people are wrong. But lab-grown diamonds, well, that's pretty obvious, right? The answer's right there in front of you. In the name. Don't need a PhD for that. Because of the rarity of naturally occurring diamonds, larger carat weight is disproportionately more valuable than in lab-grown. That's right. The only tangible difference is cost. So, does your partner treasure the story behind objects? Then a natural diamond may be the best option, so they can admire the billions of years this tiny, beautiful rock spent making its way to you. If that's less important, a lab-grown diamond may offer the opportunity to choose a larger carat. But rest assured, whether you go natural or lab-grown, a diamond is a diamond. What you end up with is entirely your choice.
Looking for more tips? Stick with me, your Helzberg Diamond Coach, and I'll make you a pro.